spot.
No, so we should search their
You look like
I was almost on the verge of tears.
Yeah.
I almost started crying.
Adam, to say a few words.
So, a really warm welcome on behalf of Trinity to you all on this very special day. As you probably know, we've been welcoming St Bonaventure students for 14 years now. This is my first year to welcome you all. We're obviously slightly delayed due to COVID, and I was told in advance by my team that it's very much like welcoming members of your family for the summer, and I would say it's very much like welcoming members, your friends, for to stay for the summer. It's been an absolute delight to have you all here. There's an enormous warmth on both sides, I think it's safe to say, a real sense of collaboration, mutual support and genuine friendship, and we'd like to thank you all and your entire team. We're really honoured to be part of this day to remember Dr. DePerro, and we hope that this tree will provide some comfort to his friends and colleagues over the months and years ahead. Thank you.
I would now like to call on the Reverend Emma Percy, chaplain of Trinity College, for your words.
Thank you. We've gathered together today to remember with thanksgiving the life of Dr. Dennis DePerro, president of St. Bonaventure, a man who believed in community and education. And we've come to remember him in this place in order to acknowledge the really deep friendship between our two colleges and the shared value that we have around education, community, building up understanding across the world. Trinity's gardens have for years been a source of joy to those who spend time here. I know it's not, you're not seeing them at their best with the heat wave and all the building blocks. But as we replant after all of the rebuilding that we've been doing, it is a wonderful way to cement our relationship and to have this living reminder of the friendship between our colleges. over the years, many from St. Bonaventure have found the gardens here a place of peace and inspiration. And in years to come, we hope that many, many more people will also do so and sit under the shade of this tree and remember the link and remember Dr. DePerro. The Bible begins in a garden, a garden full of trees. And it ends with a vision of a tree with the leaves that will be for the healing of the nations. In our world, which is so full of disorder and discord, it's important for all of us to do what we can to promote all the things that build up good relations between people, all the things that foster kindness and understanding and generosity and hospitality. So may this tree in this place be a fitting memorial to Dr. DePerro and all that he did in his life to foster community, education, the broadening of human minds, the building of relationships across the Atlantic. Our founder, Sir Thomas Pope, believed that in founding a college, he was creating a legacy in which people would carry on the importance of learning, of understanding, and of using that learning for the service of others. And one of the things he asked us to continue to do as a college was to pray for him and in memory of him and to acknowledge all our benefactors. So I offer today our founder's prayer, adding into it thanks for the life of Dr. Dennis DePerro. O God, the resurrection and life